In this video, we will be completing a process cost summary report using the FIFO, or first in, first out method. If you haven't watched the video covering the introduction to process costing, I strongly recommend that you pause this video and watch that one first. Recall this equation. The cost of beginning work in process inventory, plus the cost added this period, are equal to the cost of the units transferred out, plus the cost of ending work in process inventory. The left-hand side of the equation is called the costs to account for and are known, whereas the right-hand side of the equation is called the costs accounted for, which are unknown. The goal of the process cost summary report we are about to complete is to use the known costs to account for to assign the unknown costs accounted for. The FIFO method, which is the focus of this video, keeps costs from the prior period separate from the costs in the current period when assigning the costs accounted for. Let's take a look at an example of a process cost summary report. The example we are going to be completing is related to the Unbelievable Orange Juice Company. This is the process cost summary for the FIFO method. This is for the juice extraction department, which is department number 1, and for the month ended October 31st, 2021. The first section is for the costs charged to production, also known as the costs to account for, which are equal to the cost of beginning work in process inventory plus the costs incurred this period. This is the left-hand side of that equation that we were just talking about. I also said that the total costs to account for were known costs, meaning they should be given somewhere in the problem. And if we look over here, we see that we do have the given cost information for both the beginning work in process and the cost added this period. So first, for the cost of beginning work in process inventory, we have the direct materials. So looking over here, the beginning work in process cost for direct materials are $44,000. So we can copy that down. And then for the conversion costs, which are equal to the direct labor plus the factory overhead, are going to be, well, for beginning work in process, $13,800 plus $29,000. And that gives us $42,800. Next, the total cost of beginning work in process inventory is just the sum of those two numbers. So we can take the $44,000 plus $42,800, which gives us $86,800 for our total cost of beginning work in process inventory. We can use the same idea to finish the cost incurred this period section. First, for direct materials, the costs added this period are $76,000, so we can copy that down. For conversion costs, that's going to be the direct labor plus the factory overhead, which end up being $94,000. And then the total costs incurred this period will just be the sum of those two numbers, so $76,000 plus $94,000 equals $170,000. Finally, we can get the total cost to account for by adding the total cost of beginning work in process inventory and the total cost incurred this period, which gives us $256,800. Now, before we go any further, I just want to remind you of the purpose of this form, and that is to take the total costs to account for, the $256,800, and assign them to the costs accounted for, which we look down here, are going to be the cost of units finished this period or transferred out this period, and the ending work in process inventory. So this $256,800 is going to be split between the two numbers here, finished units this period and the total cost of ending work in process inventory. But we have a few steps to go before we get there, including the equivalent units calculation as well as the physical flow reconciliation. So first, the physical flow reconciliation. This is just taking that formula that we were working with and applying it strictly to units. So we need to calculate the units to account for and the units accounted for. And these are the same formulas as they were when they were applied to dollars. We still have the beginning work in process inventory plus what was started this period, which is equal to what was completed and transferred out, plus the ending work in process. So first we'll start with the beginning work in process inventory. If we look over here at the given unit information, we see that there were 5,000 units in beginning work in process. So we can copy that down. And then we also see that there were 19,000 units started this period. So for the units started this period, we can copy down the 19,000. The total units to account for is just the sum of those two numbers, so 19,000 plus 5,000 is equal to 24,000. Next, we can move on to the units accounted for. First, the completed and transferred out units. If we look over here, we see we have a question mark for the transferred out units, so we're going to skip that for now and come back to it. For the ending work in process, we see that there are 4,000 units, so we can copy that down. And we also know that the total units accounted for should be equal to the total units to account for. So this 24,000 can be dragged down here. And we have to ask ourselves what would have to go in the blank so that this blank plus 4,000 would equal 24,000. Well, maybe you're thinking to yourself it should be 20,000, right? If we put in 20,000 here, we have 20,000 plus 4,000, which does indeed give us 24,000. You could also take 24,000 and subtract 4,000, which would also give you the 20,000 that we needed. Alright, at this point, I want to note that everything we've done so far in these first two sections would be identical under either the weighted average or FIFO method. And when we move on to these last two sections, we'll get to some more of the differences between the two methods. Next, we have the equivalent units of production calculation. Remember that the equivalent units are the number of units that could have been started and completed given the cost incurred this period. We do the equivalent units of production calculation for the units accounted for, the units we need to assign costs to, which are equal to the units transferred out and the units in ending work in process inventory. Note that the units transferred out actually come from two different places. Some of the transferred units were started last period, so they come from the beginning work in process. The rest of the units were started this period, so they were started and completed all in the same period. Under the weighted average method, we don't differentiate between what period the transferred units started in. We simply list them all in one line titled Units Completed and Transferred Out, which blends units from last period and this period together. Under the FIFO method, which we're doing here, the units completed and transferred out get split into these two amounts here. First, we have the equivalent units to complete the beginning work in process, and then we have the units started and completed this period. So that's just one difference to watch out for between the two process costing forms. Let's begin with the equivalent units to complete beginning work in process for direct materials. Now, if we read this note over here, it says that 100% of the direct materials are added at the beginning of the process. That means that if we're dealing with oranges and orange juice, that all the oranges are added at the beginning of the juice extraction process, which is the process we're dealing with here. If we look over here, we see that there are 5,000 units in beginning work in process. And we need to find the equivalent units to complete those units with respect to direct materials. Basically, how many equivalent units of material need to still be added to complete these? Well, if these units were started as of the beginning of the period, that means they must have been started in some prior period. And in that prior period would have been when the direct materials would have been added. So how many more materials do we need to add? Well, we don't need to add any more. They would have already been added in the past period. So we can put 0 here for our equivalent units to complete beginning work in process for direct materials. Next, let's move on to the equivalent units to complete the beginning work in process for the conversion costs. Now, the conversion costs, which are the direct labor and factory overhead, function a little bit differently than the direct materials, in that they are typically added evenly throughout the process. So that means if we are 80% of the way done with these beginning work in process units, that 80% of the costs have already been added for conversion. And we need to ask ourselves, what is the equivalent units to complete those conversion costs in the beginning work in process? Well, if we are already 80% of the way done, that means we still have an additional 20% to do until we finish these units. So that means we need to take 20%, or 0.2, and multiply that by the 5,000 units, to get 1,000 equivalent units to complete our beginning work in process for conversion costs. For the equivalent units started and completed, this is a quantity that we still need to calculate. So the units started and completed are going to be equal to, first we start with the started units, which is 19,000, and then we subtract the ones that were not completed, being the ending work in process of 4,000. So if we take 19,000 and we subtract 4,000, we will get 15,000 units that were started and completed. And if these units were started and completed, that means they went through the entire process. So that means they are 100% complete with respect to both direct materials and conversion costs. So we can put 15,000 in both of those blanks. Alternatively, you can also calculate the number of units started and completed this period by subtracting the number of units in beginning inventory from the total number of units completed and transferred. So that would be 20,000 minus 5,000 equals 15,000, which is the same value we got using the other formula. Next, we can move on to the equivalent units in ending work in process for direct materials. And remember that 100% of the direct materials are added at the beginning of the process. If we assume that these ending work in process units were started this period, they would have also had the direct materials added to them. So 100% of the direct materials would be added to these 4,000 units, so we can copy that down as 4,000. Next, we can move to the equivalent units in ending work in process for conversion costs. And if we look over here, we see that there are 4,000 units in the ending work in process, and they are 70% of the way complete. So remember, we said that the conversion costs were going to be added evenly throughout the process, so that means 70% of the conversion costs would also have been added. And since these are an ending work in process, we assume that the 70% was completed this period. So that means that the equivalent units for ending work in process would be 70% multiplied by 4,000, or 0.7 times 4,000, which equals 2,800. Next, we can find the total equivalent units of production by adding the rows together. So 0 plus 15,000 plus 4,000 gives us 19,000 equivalent units of production for direct materials. And for conversion costs, we take 1,000 plus 15,000 plus 2,800, which gives us 18,800. Next, we can move on to the cost per equivalent unit of production calculation. Now, this is another difference between the weighted average and FIFO methods. Under the FIFO method, we are only going to use the cost incurred this period for our cost per equivalent unit of production calculation. Whereas when we do the weighted average method, we are going to take both the cost incurred this period and the beginning work in process inventory. Anyways, we've already used these costs before. First, for direct materials, the cost incurred this period. If we go back up here, we see the cost incurred this period for direct materials are 76,000. And we could do the same thing for the conversion costs, cost incurred this period. Here's the cost incurred this period for conversion costs, which are 94,000. Next, we can copy down the equivalent units of production. For direct materials, it was 19,000. And for conversion costs, it was 18,800. And then this division sign over here is just telling us that we need to take the cost incurred this period and divide by the equivalent units of production. So that's 76,000 divided by 19,000, which gives us 4, and then 94,000 divided by 18,800, which gives us $5. Alright, we just have one more section to complete, and this is where we're going to be using the cost per equivalent unit that we just calculated to assign this $256,800 cost to account for to the total costs accounted for, which are the cost of ending work in process and the cost of units finished this period. So first we have the cost of beginning work in process inventory. Now for the FIFO method, we want to keep the cost from different periods separate. So the cost of beginning work in process inventory, we just copy from what we had before. So if we look up here, we see the cost of beginning work in process inventory. We want the total, which is $86,800. Next, we can move on to the cost to complete the beginning work in process inventory. So the way that we do this is first for direct materials, this box here, we will take the cost per equivalent unit of production for direct materials, this column here, which is $4, and we will multiply by the equivalent units needed to complete the beginning work in process inventory, which is what we completed up here, equivalent units to complete the beginning work in process inventory, which is 0. So when we multiply those two numbers together, we will get $0. As for conversion costs, we'll do a similar process. We'll take the cost per equivalent unit of production for conversion costs, the second column, which is $5, and we will multiply by the equivalent units to complete the beginning work in process inventory. And if we look over here, we see the equivalent units to complete the beginning work in process inventory for conversion costs are 1,000, so when we multiply, we get $5,000. Next, we can find the total cost to complete the beginning work in process by just adding those two numbers together. $5,000 plus $0 gives us $5,000. Next, we can move to the cost of units started and completed this period. First, for direct materials, we will take the cost per equivalent unit of production for direct materials, which is $4, and multiply by the equivalent units started and completed, which is $15,000. For conversion costs, we'll do the same thing. Cost per equivalent unit of production is $5, and then we will multiply that by the equivalent units started and completed, which is $15,000. Then we can go ahead and we can add those two numbers together to get the total cost of units started and completed this period. So $60,000 plus $75,000 gives us $135,000. Next, we can find the total cost of units finished this period or transferred out this period by adding up these three numbers here. So first we have the cost of beginning work in process inventory, and then the cost to complete the beginning work in process inventory, and then we have to add the cost of the units started and completed in the same period. And that gives us $226,800. Next, we can move on to the cost of ending work in process inventory. So first we have the direct materials. Same kind of process here. We will take the cost per equivalent unit of production for direct materials, which is $4, and multiply by the equivalent units in ending work in process, which is 4,000. And that gives us 16,000. And then for conversion costs, we'll do the same thing. Take the $5 cost per equivalent unit and multiply by the equivalent units in ending work in process, which is 2,800. And that gives us 14,000. Finally, we can add those together. 16,000 plus 14,000 gives us the total cost of ending work in process inventory. And then we can go ahead and take the total cost of units finished this period and add the total cost of ending work in process together to get the total costs accounted for. So that's $226,800 plus $30,000 gives us $256,800. And remember that the total cost accounted for, this $256,800, should be equal to the total costs to account for, $256,800. And indeed, they do match. So that is just one way you can check your work. All right, we are finished with the process cost summary report using the FIFO method. So there's just one more thing that I want to show you, and that's in relation to this number down here, the total cost of units finished this period, which is $226,800. So that's the cost of the units that would be transferred out from this department into the next department. So if we're in the first department, which is the juice extraction department, now we're going to be sending $226,800 of units to the next department, let's say the packaging department. So along with that, we're going to have a journal entry. So I want to show you that journal entry. So this is the journal entry for transfer to the next department. And that's going to be a debit to the work in process inventory. Maybe I'll type it out, work in process inventory of the new department that you're transferring to, which in this case I'm saying is the packaging department. And that's going to be for this number here, $226,800. And then we're going to credit the work in process inventory for the department that you are transferring from, in this case the juice extraction department. And that's going to be decreasing that inventory here. And that's also going to be for $226,800. And if you happen to be in the final department, then you would be debiting the finished goods inventory because there would be no more departments to go to. All right, I think that wraps up everything I want to talk about with the process cost summary report using the FIFO method.